Everyone, this is the Dynamic Nurses Forum once again, and with me here is
Mrs. Cynthia Gwanu-Teresa.
Okay, you all know me, I'm Nurse Alex. So today we are going to be talking about kidney diseases. This is our nurse specialist, so she will introduce herself and her specialty. Then she will tell us about the kidney, then the diseases that are likely to affect the kidney, and she will tell us, educate us more on it, because she has her own specialty on that. Let's listen to you. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you for bringing this type of problem to our notice. This place is hemodialysis unit of the Pasoko District Hospital.
Okay.
And hemodialysis, in the sense that in tackling kidney problem, one of the medical interventions is hemodialysis. You have peritoneal dialysis, which we don't do because of the cost intensive of peritoneal fluid. The next option is transplant, which is not also easy. And in hemodialysis, that one is not a treatment, but it's how to help the patient. In the sense that there are major functions kidney does in our body. But in hemodialysis, some of those functions is what artificial kidney called the dialyzer can do, not all of them. In the sense that hemodialysis cannot regulate the hormone, which is one of the major functions of the kidney. It cannot secrete erythropoietin for the production of red blood cells, but it will help in reduction of fluid, potassium, urea, creatinine, those ones, it can remove it.
Okay, sorry to cut you short. When these things that you've listed now, all these potassium, urea, creatinine, if it's accumulated in the body, does it have any effects?
Yes, there are toxins in the body, which as the way God made it, the kidney is the one who's supposed to reduce the excesses in the body. But when that kidney is challenged functionally, it will not be able to remove them and they will be accumulated. And once those things are accumulated in the system, they are toxic. Because urea, virtually all the organs in the body, urea, whenever it's accumulated in the blood, it's affected. If it is in the GIT, the patient will have uremic gastritis. The patient will have uremic frost on the skin. If it enters the brain, if you see them as if to say they are mental, only when because the urea level in the brain cells is high. That's the major thing. And it also helps in hemolyzing the red blood cells. That is why whenever there is challenge, not only the fact that the kidney cannot secrete erythropoietin for the secretion of red blood cells, it cannot last because the urea will not hemolyze the red blood cells and they reduce their lifespan, leading the person to anemia.
Okay. So, can you help us list some of these kidney problems?
My sister, kidney problem is enormous. But there are basic issues. Whenever somebody has it, definitely the person knows that he's already on the track to that. Something like hypertension. You know, kidney can regulate BP.
Yes.
And BP can also lead to increase in blood pressure, can also lead to kidney problem. In the sense, if you remember our renin angiotensin mechanism,
yes,
where the renin increases when it is high and then reduces when it is low due to feedback mechanism. Now also diabetes, in which case we lead to diabetic nephropathy. When the sugar level in the system is so high that it accumulates in the kidney, it affects it. Again, sickle cell, whenever they are having problem because of the sickle lack of the red blood cells,
yeah,
some of them will be stopped in the kidney tubules. And in the process, the kidney can be challenged. It will not be able to do its work well. Again, vomiting and diarrhea. Whenever the body is dehydrated, the kidney cannot function well. Kidney needs enough of water in order to do its work. So, in case of maybe hyperemesis gravidarum in women that are pregnant for the first 3 months, first trimester, In that case, that woman, whenever the woman is vomiting, definitely must try as much as possible in order to replenish. In children that are having diarrhea and vomiting, in pediatrics, you can't joke with diarrhea and vomiting. It's a very serious something. Because one of the major organs that is being affected is the kidney. Mm. And bear in mind that this kidney problem, most of the time, is not a sudden illness that will start overnight. No, it's a gradual process.
That's why it's chronic.
Yes, in chronic kidney problem, it's a gradual process. Just like when you are sending soldiers to the war front. Mm. You know, assuming you sent 100 of them, they will come back, some will die, some will have amputated hand, some will have amputated leg. Mm. And those ones that have those challenges, they will not fight as those ones yes. that their bodies are still okay. That is what is happening on the nephrons of the kidney. So whenever any stress or any trauma or anything, some of them will be dying gradually, the person will not know. The only acute stage is when the thing is so sudden. Mm. Maybe the woman during the course of delivery bled. When the woman bled, that one, what you will do, when immediately they give enough fluid and enough transfusion, the kidney picks up. Or the person had accident, the kidney is challenged. Maybe the person bled either because of kidney or even bones. Mm. The person lost a lot of fluid during the course of burns.
Yes.
So in that case, it is an acute stage. So once you replace those things, the person recovers. Or if the person must have something like prostate enlargement, when it presses hard, or urinary tract infection, if the patient is on catheter for a long time, after some time, it has to be, yes, these are the challenges of the kidney. Because anything that will back, force the backflow of urine back to the kidney, we need to adapt. So in case of acute, they normally say that it may be either prerenal, intrarenal, or postrenal. Prerenal, if it is due to because of shortage of blood
yes.
to the kidney. Intrarenal, it might be either as a result of trauma or as a result of infection that hits the kidney. When those things are being corrected, the kidney recovers. Postrenal, in case of prostate enlargement, because those things will obstruct the flow of urine, causing backlog of urine. And with all these toxins, it will go back to the kidney and cause some damages there. So, deranging the functional level of the kidney. These are the major things you will see. But in case of chronic kidney disease, it's a gradual process.
Yeah.
And gradual in the sense that it will not cause any harm, the person will not even know. So, if the person that does not go to hospital to check the BP doesn't even know that he or she is hypertensive, or the diabetes, they will be treating it as is supposed. The nephrons of the kidney will be dying gradually, even hyper nephropathy. We are seeing them. Yes, we are seeing them generally now. But the major thing in that case is that if it is only IVAN, if the person comes, some of them, their BP is always on the low side. They are normal.
Mm-hmm.
You will be battling with dehydration and the blood. Maybe if the person misses the first line of management in treatment, that second line of management, most of the patients react to it. And it also affects the kidney.
Okay.
So in such a situation, all those things, gradual destruction of the functional level of the kidney.
Okay, so these things you've mentioned just now, is those are the likely causes.
Yes.
Things that can lead to kidney failure.
Yes.
Okay, so now you've told us about dialysis, how once the kidney fails, the only solution, is there any drug that can be used to restore the kidney in acute stage?
In acute stage, once you remove the causative organism or the causative issue, the kidney recovers. Just like maybe the person bled during the course of delivery or in form of accident or in case of burns, the person lost a lot of fluid. Once those things are being removed, you see the kidney piece. Or someone that has prostate enlargement, when the surgery is done and everything gets normal, you see the kidney picks up. But in case of chronicity, in fact, only grace of God. And for the person to be alive, even if the person has the money to plan for that transplant, the person must be on hemodialysis.
Okay, thank you very much.
By training the individual, if the person has money, the person can move forward. But now, we have seen in this country that, in fact, management of chronic kidney disease, and it's increasing, is enormous.
Mm.
Because some of them will come here, those that have friends, you call your friends in peace. The moment the person sees you and they are missed call, the person will not pick because of the money involved.
Yes.
You can imagine, this is a government-owned hospital. This is the least. If the person, let's say, you are doing two times dialysis with that, dialysis is what you're supposed to have three times a week.
Like, how much does it cost to get a section of dialysis?
A section of dialysis here, as at now, with access, 21,000. Without access, between 26 to 31,000. If the access is 1,000, is 26. One sided is 26,000. But if it is two sided, is 31,000. And that is not including both the high BP drugs. If the person is hypertensive, the erythropoietin the person is taking, every other challenge in case of infection, the monies are not there. This is just to do the, that some part of the kidney, the cleaning, and the person.
Thank you very much. So what is the advice you have for people over there just to be able to try and live a healthy life, to avoid things that will affect the kidney? What are some of the advice, health educations you would like to give people out there on either drugs or whatever thing that you know is a risk factor to kidney failure?
Well, what we are preaching now is preventive nephrology.
Okay.
That is health education on how we have to take care of our kidneys. Number one, if you know that you have the risk factor, maybe you have your relation that has suffered from kidney problems, hypertension, diabetes, sickle cell, whenever such person has such a challenge, first thing is to go for medical frequent checks. And most of the time, we know that hypertension is a silent killer.
Yes.
Unless you go, you will not know. So we advocate that everybody will try as much as possible to be going for, at least, even if you don't have money for anything, if you go to the hospital, let them check your BP. Again, urinalysis is very important. It's minor, but to me, it's very important because these are the places you begin to notice stress of protein, protein 1 plus, 2 plus. Don't ignore it. It's telling you that something very important is trying to go and hit the kidneys.
Okay.
And that might be a way to help you because it will also guide the doctor. There are some drugs that are not kidney friendly, like non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. If the person has gotten such history, it will now help the doctor on the type of drug to place that patient. And again, we add advice on our eating habits.
Yeah.
Now, people have forgotten fruits and vegetables. These snacks, meat pie, yogurt, all these
junk foods.
Please, even from childhood, you will see some parents going to buy all sorts of sweets, candies for children to go to school with. But you will see a piece of carrot. To buy a piece of garden egg, that one, no. They will tell you after all. But these things go a long way, gradually destroy these things we don't know. And we must exercise ourselves, especially on the part of those that are obese. Morning, evening, exercise, no matter. Even if you can't do it outside, there are some exercises you can do within your home. And we nurses, medical personnel, whenever you are in the world, after asking patient to do the test, when the test is out, please, madam, see the doctor that write this test for you. Let him or her explain to you what and what there is that is inside. Whenever they say you have a trace of floating, madam, please remember, come back in a week's time or 2 weeks' time to repeat this urinalysis again and other functions, because there are many things that can cause more harm than good in the future. So we'll be able to educate them no matter where you are. Drink water. Plain water is better than drinking all this canned juice, Coke, or all of them. Take plenty water to flush. If you are taking your oral drugs, take enough fluid. If after eating, take enough fluid. It helps to flush your kidney and keep the nephrons in a healthy position.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
You've heard from our nurse specialists here. So she has told us, if we leave her to continue, she will have enough to tell us. But for now, We'll have to go, and maybe next time we'll hear more from her. Thank you very much for coming on the show.
Thank you for coming here and inquiring from us, because we are always eager to aim up, because some people will still tell you, I've not heard of this. I've not heard of this. Let all of us be the agent and the talk and the speak and the educate, so that our people will hear. Because the Bible said that my people die because of lack of knowledge. But if we're able to educate them, they will know.
So we've heard. With this little we've heard, I hope we will try and keep to most of these healthy livings, just to avoid our kidney being damaged. Because when it is damaged, the care, it's not an easy thing. To get a section of dialysis is 21,000, and if the kidney is badly damaged, you need more than just a section in a week. Just imagine how much that will cost, even to a poor Nigerian. So my people, let us try and live healthy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.